So, right, we were talking about the plasmid. Herbert Boyer and Stanley Cohen, what they did is they have isolated the plasmid which is having the ORI gene. Right. Now, what is the use of this plasmid? Plasmid is used as a vector here. So, it is acting as a vector. Now, question is, what is a vector? Vector is any DNA molecule which can carry the foreign gene or the gene of interest or the desired gene into the host. Such a kind of DNA molecule is called as a vector. Vector anedi any DNA molecule kavachu. Dani capacity enti, vector yokka function enti, it should carry the desired gene. Adi desired gene ni carry cheyali. Ekkadiki host loki pampichadaniki. So that is the function of the vector. So we have many types of vectors. In that, Boyer and Cohen were using, what is the vector here? Plasmid as a vector. So they are taking the help of the plasmid for carrying the desired gene into the host. So what they did is, they have isolated this plasmid. So, right, after isolating, what they did, let's understand. So, after isolating this plasmid out, they are cutting this plasmid by using an enzyme restriction endonuclease. So, the circular plasmid has now cut. So, you can see here. Which enzyme they have used is restriction endonuclease. So this is the enzyme they have used to cut the plasmid. Plasmid ni cut chesindru by using restriction endonuclease enzyme ni used is. Now what they are doing is they are inserting this desired gene. So this is the gene of interest, right? What is the gene? Tetracycline resistance gene. Inserting into this plasmid. So, this plasmid lo insert chesina gene. Now, there should be some enzyme which helps in binding this tetracycline resistance gene with the plasmid. Right. Now, what is that enzyme is? DNA ligase. DNA ligase. So, DNA ligase helps to bind the tetracycline resistance gene to the plasmid DNA. Now, after binding, so this is DNA ligase. DNA ligase helps to bind the gene of interest to the plasmid. Now, what formed is recombinant DNA is formed. Such DNA is known as recombinant DNA or chimeric DNA. Yes, it's a combination of two DNAs. One is a plasmid DNA and tetracycline resistance gene. Andukane ee DNA name antunnam rDNA or chimeric DNA. Now what they are doing? Now they are transferring this rDNA into the host. Now who is the host? Imagine E. coli. So ikkada vallu teeskunna, they have chosen the host as E. coli. Escherichia coli. Now what they are doing is they are transferring this rDNA into the E. coli bacteria. Right. Now this rDNA has entered into the E. coli. Now E. coli is now transformed, change ayindi, because previously E. coli was not having this rDNA, but now it has the recombinant DNA in the cell. So it's a genotype changed. So that means what? It will, the phenotype will also change. So this sort of a cell is known as a transformed cell. So here, now you understood why this plasmid is called as a vector. Yes, plasmid is called as a vector because the plasmid has incorporated the desired gene and it carried into the host. Host loki pampichadaniki ee DNA use ayindi kabatti andukane plasmid use ayindi kabatti plasmid ni vector ani antunnam. Right. Now in the host what happening is the gene because ikkada ORI undi. So ORI pakkane beside ORI we have linked this gene tetracycline resistance gene. Right. Now what is going to happen is when the plasmid is undergoing replication, that means what, even the desired gene or gene of interest or tetracycline resistance gene is also increasing in its number. Plasmid replicate aitunna koddi gene of interest, mana gene of interest edaithe undo, desired gene edaithe undo, tetracycline resistance gene edaithe undo, it is also replicating. You can see its number is also increasing. That means what? Now the plasmid which I have chosen is what? The plasmid which is having an ORI gene, right? And because of the ORI gene, because the gene of interest is attached to the ORI gene, linked to the ORI gene, so whenever the plasmid is undergoing replication, even the gene of interest is also undergoing replication. So that means what? This sort of a plasmid is not only used as a vector but also helping in increasing the number of the desired gene. అంటే ఈ ఇలాంటి ప్లాస్మిడ్ ఏదైతే ఓఆర్ఐ ఉన్నటువంటి ప్లాస్మిడ్ ఏదైతే ఉందో అది జీన్ ని హోస్ట్ లోకి పంపించడానికి ఉపయోగపడమే కాకుండా దా జీన్ ని ఇంక్రీజ్ చేయడానికి కూడా, క్లోన్ చేయడానికి కూడా, టు గెట్ మల్టిపుల్ కాపీస్ ఆఫ్ ద జీన్ ఆల్సో ఇట్ ఈస్ హెల్పింగ్. అందుకనే ఇలాంటి వెక్టార్ ని వి కాలింగ్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అ క్లోనింగ్ వెక్టార్. So such a vector is known as a cloning vector. So in this host, the gene of interest have increased its number, multiple copies have obtained, clones have obtained this clone. We have increased the number of the tetracycline genes. Right. Now what is going to happen? The second thing is, this gene is also undergoing gene expression. Transcription, translation to produce what? To produce a protein. Imagine X protein. Imagine X protein which can detoxify the tetracycline. Ante ippudu nenu ippudu ee bacterial cell meeda tetracycline add chesna. Now is this E. coli cell is resistant against tetracycline? Yes. Why? Because it is having the gene now, tetracycline resistant gene. It is producing the protein. Now this protein, X protein, can able to detoxify the tetracycline. Ante ee bacteria tetracycline antibiotic vesina kuda bratukutundi because dan daggara protein undi. Aa protein denni detoxify chestadi? Tetracycline ni. Anduke aa gene em antunnam? Tetracycline resistance gene. So this is how Herbert Bowyer and Stanley Cohen have constructed the first recombinant DNA or chimeric DNA, which is a combination of plasmid DNA and the tetracycline resistance gene. Now, they have sent this rDNA into the host. So here, multiple copies of the gene are also getting. So we are getting many copies of the tetracycline resistance gene. And not only that, the gene is undergoing expression in this bacterial cell to produce a protein which can detoxify tetracycline. So this was the first rDNA process was done by Bowyer and Cohen. Now let's see the general process of recombinant DNA. So what is the general procedure? Oka rDNA technology lo general process em untadi. So for that, I am taking an example.